Google is leaning into the durability for sustainability narrative with the Pixel 9 phones, and with the promise of 7 years of software updates, it might be tempting to take those claims of durability at face value. The Pixel 9s are supposedly twice as durable as the Pixel 8s based on drop test results, and we're keen to find out if the internal structure has changed to warrant this claim. Despite the improvements Google has made, these phones will still break. The screens are going to crack, the batteries will wear out, and there's lots of things in between that can go wrong too. So yes, durability is great, but there are limits to how much abuse this device can take. So we still need to know how repairable the thing is overall. A quick disclaimer before we start the teardown, we work with Google to provide spare parts through our store, but our teardowns are performed independent of any input from Google. On to the teardown. Expecting a similar construction to past Pixels, I'm going to go through the screen to gain access to the internals. The screen opening process seems to run smoother than most, as there's an opening almost immediately. Running around the edges with a pick cuts through the adhesive easily enough. Too easily. On closer inspection, I can see signs of delamination on the screen, and turning on the phone confirms my worst fears. Even with careful use of heat and light but persistent suction with our anti-clamp, the display layers separated during the removal process, unfortunately breaking the display. With the panel off, there's not much more to do on this side, so I'm turning my attention to the back of the device. This type of damage to the screen is exactly why screen entry designs are not ideal. It's not the easiest or safest way to get into the device if all you want to do is replace a battery. The iPhone 14 solved a similar problem pertaining to back glass replacement by implementing a dual entry design. And while the Pixel 9 Pro XL adopts a similar system, the execution is clearly something that Google needs to work on. Still, it's great to not have to remove a screen if all you want to do is replace a battery. The back cover removal is a far less stressful experience, and notice how the exterior shell of the camera bump is incorporated into the cover. Once the back cover is loosened, there's another flex cable here connecting the flash and the temperature sensor to the mainboard. Those components remain in the back cover housing. We looked at the temperature sensor on the Pixel 8 Pro last year. It's a cool feature that I'd rather have than not, but it's been a year and I still have no idea what I'd do with it. The good news is that if you have the base model Pixel 9, you won't need to worry about this dilemma, as it doesn't come with the temperature sensor. Peeling back stickers seems like the only sensible option in what's now a pretty unintuitive design. Sure enough, there's a hidden screw under here which releases this bracket, and that gives me a path to removing the wireless charging assembly. So now I'm keeping an eye out for hidden screws, but this second sticker isn't being evil, it's just a sticky anchor of sorts. I can remove the screws and bracket to reveal the interconnect cables which, once removed, and in this guy's particular example unscrewed too, it gives me a clear view of the battery. The Pixel 9 Pro XL uses the same type of sliding saw style pull tab mechanism that I struggled with in the Pixel 8 Pro. I'm really not a fan of these, but I notice in the bottom corner of the battery a link to online guides. Maybe Google has some pointers on how to use this style of pull tab. Or maybe not. Unlike the QR codes found in the Microsoft Surface tablets and the Framework 13, this particular QR code is quick to lead me to an online chat session. No guides to be found here. I'll have to figure this out myself. Thankfully, I can grow an additional 3 hands at will to help secure the phone while I try to cut through the adhesive. My colleagues tell me they had better luck here, but I'm out of patience and I opt for a few drops of isopropyl alcohol. Even then, the tolerances are so tight I can't find an easy path in. Let's let this battery marinate in the alcohol for just a little bit. The lower speaker and daughter board, which is now thankfully home to the USB-C port, seems more approachable, and the two along with the haptic motor come away easily enough. Once again, it's not entirely clear what should come out next, so I'm going around and removing all the screws I can find. The larger of two brackets seems promising, and after prodding and prying, the bracket comes up, only for me to realize there was a spring latch on one side. Whoops. There's another couple of press connectors under the bracket and another hidden screw under one of the flex cables. That frees the millimeter wave antenna and finally allows the full removal of the mainboard and rear camera assembly. The camera assembly is held in place by 3 press connectors that are only accessible from the rear side of the mainboard. Bear that in mind if you find yourself replacing this assembly. From left to right, we have a 50 megapixel Samsung ISOCELL GNK sensor powering the main wide-angle camera, followed by a 48 megapixel Sony IMX858 sensor on the ultra-wide, and lastly, another 48 megapixel Sony IMX858 sensor on the 5x optical zoom camera. With the phone nearly completely disassembled, I'm going back to the battery problem I had earlier. Even after dousing it in isopropyl alcohol, it's still not readily going to budge, and I finally gave in to my frustration and pried it up with a spudger, something you absolutely should not do with a charged battery. It worked, kind of. I accidentally popped out the heatsink for the screen and revealed the underside of the battery in the process. This new opening makes it easy for me to slide a pick in and cut away the remaining adhesive. The battery is out, but gosh, what a mess. The only difference between the Pixel 9 Pro and the Pixel 9 Pro XL is the size of this battery, the XL receiving the larger 19.68 watt-hour pack compared to the 18.28 watt-hour found in the Pixel 9 Pro. The mainboard itself is powered by Google's new Tensor G4 chip with 16GB of LPDDR5 RAM to assist with the new AI capabilities. Also new to the Pixel 9 line, SOS satellite messaging via Samsung's S5400 Exynos 5G modem and a partnership with Skylo, a Palo Alto satellite IoT company that is now squared off against Apple and Globalstar in competition for the satellite messaging market. So how does the Pixel 9 series increase its durability by twofold? We've already seen that the internal structure has changed, but we wanted to get an even closer look at the internals. To do that, we teamed up with the excellent folks at Lumafield to bring you these CT scans. This stunning image produced by Lumafield's Neptune scanner is packed with information. From the overall layout of components inside the device to the individual lens elements and magnets in the telescopic camera, there's an awful lot to see. But if we're looking at the claim of increased durability, this would be the area of most interest. There are multiple repairability benefits to introducing dual-entry design in smartphones, one of which is the additional structural rigidity provided by the mid-plate that the screen sits on. Between the back cover, the mid-plate, and the front screen, the mid-plate is the sturdiest of the three. Without it, there's no central column of support through the phone to absorb and transmit shock impacts away from the screen and back cover. This can clearly be seen on the Pixel 8 Pro. The Pixel 9 Pro XL definitely gives us a run for our money. It had a couple of very interesting surprises that we love, and a couple that we could do without. Starting with the cons, the battery removal experience is inexcusably poor, especially when considering that Apple and Samsung have already figured this out. The screens are also very fragile. Having had four of our Teardown engineers run through the process with as many phones, I can safely say that the problem wasn't on our side. As for the pros, it really does seem that Google's claims of doubling their durability on the Pixel 9s is true. Accidental drops break a lot of screens, so this is a very welcome development. The dual-entry design is the MVP here, not only for increasing durability, but also for improving the overall repairability of the Pixel phones. The simple fact that you don't have to remove the screen to get to the battery will empower many would-be DIYers. And last but not least, Google's continued commitment to releasing guides, parts, and their concrete commitment to 7 years of software updates really flexes their sustainability credentials. With that in mind, the Google Pixel 9 Pro XL receives a provisional repairability score of 5 out of 10. There's definitely room for improvement here, but Google is showing a genuine desire to design for sustainability, and we're excited to see where they take the Pixel line next year.